described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Films Media Group presents Issues in Psychology.
Psychological research doesn't just happen in a vacuum. It has social consequences. And this raises important questions.
For example, how far should psychologists be allowed to go in the name of research?
And could psychological research actually have unintended, harmful consequences for some individuals and groups?
Are psychologists telling us about human behaviour in general, as they often claim, or simply about behaviour in a relatively small part of the world?
Claire Parsons.
These questions are really important because they come up all the time in research, and there's no agreement on the answers. This is what makes them issues or disputes in psychology.
And here, we'll look at some of the most important of these issues in psychology and clarify them.
Well, that's the idea. And the first one is ethics. Psychologists use people in their experiments and observations. So what can and can't they do with their participants? Where's the line drawn?
Titles: Issues in Psychology. 1. Ethics. Dr. Steve Taylor.
Remember Stanley Milgram's obedience experiments?
1961.
The false draw. The electric shock machine. The pressure on participants.
I'm responsible for anything that happens here. Continue, please.
And the shocking results.
The Milgram study is a really important one to bring into ethics because the storm it created played such a big role in the development of stricter ethical guidelines for protection of participants.
He might be dead in there.
But what exactly are ethics?
In general terms, ethics refers to the duty of care psychologists owe to those participating in their research. That's an obligation to look after their interests and make sure they're not harmed in any way. So ethics are really just rules of conduct that psychologists are expected to follow when they carry out research. And we can understand their significance in psychology today by taking a trip back to the past. Psychology hasn't always had these rules of conduct. John Watson demonstrated that classical conditioning also applies to humans, but terrified a small boy in the process by banging an iron bar over his head. Wendell Johnson and his assistant Mary Tudor, looking at speech problems in children, actually tried to induce stuttering in a group of orphan children by giving them negative speech therapy and making fun of the way they spoke. Landis's study of emotion and facial expression involved instructing people to cut off the head of a white rat, and if they refused, Landis picked up the knife and chopped the rat's head off himself.
But you just can't do that sort of research anymore.
She drops a knife in a wastebasket.
There are much stricter ethical guidelines in place. So let's have a look at some of the most important ones.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.